Good morning, church. It's Saturday morning, and we're working off again out of Matthew chapter number 28, as he talked about going into all the world and making disciples and baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and then teaching them. And we're talking about how we do that as Baptists. The formation of Baptists on May the 8th, 1845, was because, number one, we felt like missions was primary, and many other groups were disagreeing with that. And so we formulated to say, hey, we're going to form mission boards. We're going to see people around the world who are willing to go and to declare Christ to the nations. But another controversy that helped to formulate Southern Baptists is baptism itself. In fact, that's where we get our name. We are not named after John the Baptist. We are just called Baptists because baptism was an important issue of our founding fathers, if you will. Those who established this denomination felt like that baptism was not something we could do willy-nilly, but we needed to do it according to the scripture. And they looked to the Bible, and the Bible was very clear, and it still is today, it hasn't changed, that baptism is by immersion. In fact, the word baptizo in the Greek is the word we've anglicized to baptism, is actually means to immerse, to dunk under completely. It is a picture of the death and the burial as someone is laid underneath the water. That's a picture of death and burial. When they come out of the water, that's a picture of the resurrection and that they're walking to walk in newness of life. And you don't get that picture with a little sprinkling of water or pouring of a Dixie cup over someone's head called fusion. And so many groups baptized infants, babies, and then baptize them by sprinkling or pouring a little water over their forehead. They would baptize even kids that came of age. They hadn't been born again, but they were that time to be confirmed, and they were baptizing them at that point. Or anybody that just wanted to be baptized. And then they were baptizing them wrongfully, or at least in my estimation, unbiblically, and they were baptizing them by sprinkling and baptizing them by fusion and other ways that the Bible does not require. And so when they formulated the Southern Baptist Convention in 1845, they established the doctrine that baptism is an important doctrine and it needs to be done the biblical way. And here are some of the things that came out. Number one, who can be baptized? Only those who are born again by the Spirit of God. Only those who profess openly Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. A little child can't do that until a person comes to the knowledge of Jesus Christ, having repented of sin, receiving the Holy Spirit, they are not to be baptized. And so that's who can be baptized, and only those. The mode of baptism was to be by immersion. Again, a dunking underneath, a burial, if you will, under the water, and a resurrection. Who is to perform the ordinance of baptism? Some groups, just if your child came at that time and daddy wanted to baptize him out in the backyard in the swimming pool, just baptize him. Just anybody could do that. Southern Baptists understood that it is the church that baptizes. When the disciples were told to go into all the world and make disciples, baptizing them, that was an ordinance given to the church, not just to individuals. And so therefore, for instance, in Emmanuel Baptist Church, if you want to be baptized, you present yourself to the church. The church affirms that commitment you've made to the Lord. And then the church baptizes you. And the church authorizes who can baptize. In our church, myself and Brother Trevor are the two that are can baptize. Now, we at different times will confirm that somebody else, if somebody's grandfather or dad is a deacon in our church and they want to be baptized by them, I will ask the church for permission. The church says, sure, and they can, as long as they're commissioned by the church to do that. And so that is the reasons why some of them separated and became a denomination. Baptism is an important issue. Now, another issue that we're going to talk about is landmarkism. There was a group who said that you could trace all the way from the days of Jesus and John the Baptist them, and that they're the only church. They're the only true church. Everybody else may be friends of the Father, but they're the only true church because they come all the way through, and that none of the rest of us are part of that. And the Southern Baptist Convention separated itself from the landmarkers, which was J.M. Pendleton and J.R. Graves, separated from them. I'm not going to go into that controversy. But there was a third, another controversy that was a major issue during that time, and it was the slavery issue. The North and the South had separated itself societally, and they had differences of opinions on the issue of slavery. And so when the convention began, it began in the South, and therefore it was called the Southern Baptist Convention. Though many of them did not hold slaves and did not agree with slavery, the convention itself is called the Southern Baptist Convention because there was a separation between the North and the South. And there were many cultural differences between the North and the South. So the Southern Baptist Convention began on May the 8th, 1845, for the purpose of missions, to send people into the world, to baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, by immersion, to bring them into the fellowship of God's people, and then in those various fellowships around the world, what we call churches, then they're to be taught to understand all that Christ has commanded us and to keep the commands of our Lord. That's how we came into existence. We'll talk more again on Monday. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the creation of a denomination that has its heart and mind on reaching the world for Christ. We know only you can save people, but Father, we thank you that you have commissioned us that we can be a part of that process. Help us do it wisely, and help us, Father, to do it often. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.